this is an update in my continuing coverage of KIC 8462852, or Boyajian star, from March 3rd, 2017. For the backstory on this fascinating star, see the other videos on my channel, starting with my first update of April of last year. Boyajian star remains as much of a mystery as it has always been, with a host of new natural explanations on the table, and the alien megastructure hypothesis remains unlikely but is still in the mix. As I reported earlier this year, one theory regarding the type of alien megastructure that theoretically could be involved is stellar lifting, a hypothetical technology that allows a civilization to harvest materials from their star. Along with this theory came a prediction that on February 21st or thereabouts, the next dimming event would occur. I found this prediction interesting but highly unlikely due to the alien nature of the theory. That said, it was quite difficult to pin down exactly what happened on the 21st. There was a good reason for this. Boyajian's star was behind the sun at this time and therefore quite difficult to observe on Earth, and apparently the weather was bad for what ground observation could be done. As a result, there was no data as would normally be available through the American Association of Variable Star Observers, who are monitoring this star nightly and plotting what they see in order to catch the next dip. The star was, however, under observation by the Swift spacecraft and the main science team investigating the star led by Dr. Boyajian. On a German language news site that I cannot pronounce, link in the description below, members from the team said in an interview that they did not see a dip. Dr. Heindel notes that Swift only observed the star for a few minutes and may not have caught it, but Dr. Boyajian notes that the dips that Kepler observed tended to last for several days, so it's likely that it would have caught it. Dr. Heindel's next prediction for a dip consistent with his hypothesis is February of 2019. And that brings us to a very different kind of prediction, this one from Dr. Boyajian's blog, link also in the description below. There she gives a loose prediction on the next dimming event based on the idea that if you assume that the two large dimming events that Kepler observed are related, then the next dimming event could start in a window of several months before May of this year and several months after. Now, Dr. Boyajian is careful to caution in that post that it's merely a possibility that the two events were related and this prediction may not happen at all. But if it doesn't happen, it would suggest that whatever is going on at the star isn't periodic, at least short term. That might bolster some of the explanations that involve interstellar dust clouds moving past, or irregularities with the star itself, which one theory suggests that it's in the process of calming down after recently eating a planet. So there you have it, the predicted February 21st dimming event does not appear to have happened as far as anyone knows, and the mystery at Boyajian's star continues. It truly is one strange star, and no matter if the explanation is natural, which is far more likely, or alien, it's going to be something rare and interesting regardless. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently with a new book due out in the coming weeks. It's called Supermind and Toys with Ideas of Superintelligence and Simulation Theory. And be sure to check out my other books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.